In this video, you're going to learn how to set up your product feed for your Google Shopping campaigns by directly uploading your products into Google Merchant Center. This is by far the quickest and easiest way to set up your product feed and get your campaigns going if you have 10 products or less. To do this, we log into our Google Merchant Center account by going to merchants.google.com. On the left-hand menu, we're going to click on products. If you haven't tried creating a feed at all yet, it will show you this screen. Just click on add product. If you do already have a feed set up, but you want to set up with our method today, just go to products and then all products on the left-hand menu and click the plus sign. We'll start by setting our country of sale and language. This is where you're going to be selling to, of course. Make sure you check both boxes for free listings and shopping ads. If you don't see free listings here, it means you have to enable it in Merchant Center programs. I have a video on how to set up your free Google Shopping ads. I'll leave a link to that video down below this one. The first section here is the product identifier section. Your product identifier is usually a unique number in a database, depending on your region, that identifies your product in the marketplace. It's also called the GTIN. If you create your own products or you don't have a GTIN, you do have to provide a brand and MPN, a manufacturer part number, instead of a GTIN. We'll go over those in a bit. You can usually get the GTIN from your supplier or by looking at the barcode that's on the product. It's a vital signal to Google, and they use this to compare with other products that have been submitted by other advertisers. You will still have to optimize the feed, but the GTIN does make life easier. And you can see here that there are different types of GTINs, which are the UPC in North America, the EAN in Europe, the JAN in Japan, ISBN for books, ITF14 for multipacks. You can often search Google too and find someone else selling the same product and check if they have the correct identifier too and use theirs. Like I said, if you don't have the GTIN, you can add in the MPN and the brand. If you want to add the MPN, just click advanced to see the MPN field and you can add it there too. This MPN is the manufacturer part number. It's assigned by the manufacturer and it's unique to every product. Someone searching for a Toyota air filter can search for a specific MPN that's tied to their specific make and model. So it is a good idea to provide it if you can. What if your product doesn't have an MPN? If you don't have a GTIN, it's mandatory to provide a brand and MPN. With the GTIN, you can't make it up if it doesn't exist, but you can with the MPN. I recommend just adding in the SKU number if you don't have the MPN. Just be sure to make it unique to every product in your feed. Next, we have the product data. Let's go through these one by one. The ID is the unique identifier for our product in our catalog. Don't reuse the same ID for different products and stay consistent with it. The ID will be the link between the primary and supplemental feed, so it's an important and required product attribute. You don't have to fill in the ID with SEO keywords or anything like that. It's just used as a key identifier for our products. It's often our SKU, but it can honestly be anything. This is going to be helpful for finding your products in your campaigns when you want to edit your bids manually. So I do recommend having it as the product name or something that allows you to easily differentiate between products. Keep in mind that when you have variants, each variant should have a unique ID. Just add that in and let's move on to the next fields. Next, we have the title of our product. The title is the most important product field for Google. Your Google Shopping campaigns will perform much better if you spend the time to craft an optimized title. What makes a good title for our product? You don't necessarily want to have the same title that's on your e-commerce store. A lot of stores do this and it's a big mistake. Look at this example here. They're selling this backpack called Lita, but how would Google know what is a Lita? A better title would be a sling backpack in gray, 40 liters. See how that's much more descriptive and also optimized towards what a customer might search? So first we want to do some keyword research and see what your shoppers are searching for when you want to show your product. If you're selling laptops, think about what your potential customer will type in to find the laptop he needs. All right, laptop is probably going to be in that query. Searching for branded laptops is highly likely, so we'll put the brand and the model in that title too. The hard drive capacity is probably pretty important, so we'll cram that in as well. Does it have an external graphics card? Great, we'll put that in too. How about RAM? That's important. The processor type isn't unimportant as well. Wait, screen size? That's important too. One completely made up title might go something like Dell XSP 19 9978 laptop, 13 inches, FHD, Intel i1, 128 gigabytes, SSD, 32 gigabytes of RAM. Do note, Google Shopping won't display the whole title, but the first 35 to 70 characters, depending on the shopping ad layout. So fit the most important things in the first part. The limit for the title is 150 characters. We want to use most of the the characters, not because it might show up to customers, but to let Google know as much information as possible about the product. Even if the 32 gigabytes of RAM doesn't show up in the title that the shopper sees, it's still taken into account by Google. So your laptop might still show up when someone is searching for Dell laptops that have 32 gigabytes of RAM. There isn't a universal formula for the best title, but there are some best practices depending on the niche and the products. With generic products, you want to put in the brand plus product type plus color plus material plus size. So let's say 3M adhesive tape, black, 60 inches by 1 inch. If you're selling jewelry, one title might be consisted of the brand plus weight plus shape plus style plus material. An example might be something like your brand, 14 carats, yellow, gold, pendant, classic. For apparel, you might use gender plus keyword one, keyword two, plus brand, plus color, plus product type. For anything related to sports, you'd go with brand plus sport plus product type. Plus color. As you can see, there isn't a universal formula and it will be highly dependent on your niche, what your competitors are using, and what shoppers are expecting. There isn't an easy way to A/B test changes, but you can change a single product title, take note when you changed it, monitor impressions, clicks, and conversions, and compare it to the previous period. It's not a perfect method because you have to take into account a few more things like seasonality, but until Google gives us something better, we can only do it like this. Optimizing titles is so important, and we have a blog post just on this. You can check that out with a link that I'll leave below this video. Next, we'll add in the brand of our products. If you're selling branded products, you definitely want to input the correct brand here. If you created your own brand, don't fret. You can just put in your own brand name here. It's a mandatory field and especially important if you're listing a new product on the marketplace. Let's now look at the description. Since you can't show your product in person and let the customer see, feel, and wear the product, you have to describe it to them. Arguably, the description product attribute isn't that important for the customer unless you're showing up in the free listings. But Google does take into account what's written here, and it helps with properly categorizing and making Google better with understanding what your product is and what problem it solves. The character limit is 5,000 characters. You can see here for this white noise machine, we've kept it pretty simple, descriptive of the product. Of course, you can go into much more detail when you create your description too. Next, we have the landing page link. When someone clicks on the ad, you have to send them somewhere, right? This one is pretty straightforward, and this product attribute should contain a link to the product page. Just go to your store, copy the URL, make sure the URL is clean, and paste it into this box. Next, we have the image URL, which is one of the most important parts of your ad because it gets the most real estate. Look how much space they take up, plus look how eye-catching they are. You know that humans are visual creatures and react well to anything that's visual. That's why you need to have impeccable images of your products. Like I said already, people can't feel your product, so be sure to have high quality images ready for them to look at. Keep in mind that you can't have any promotional elements on the image, so no logo, no offers like free shipping or anything like that on the image. Your product should be visible with a white background. You'll see images with models and images that aren't on a white background, but Google seems to be fairly lax about that. As long as the image isn't offensive, doesn't have borders, promotional elements, it will show up. But keep in mind that you can always get a disapproved product if Google wants to enforce their rules. My suggestion would be to check out your competition and niche and see how they're using the main images. For this example here, I'd have a model with the t-shirt on, but have a ready image of the t-shirt alone on a white background, just in case Google decides to disapprove our model image. To add in your image, you can paste a link to your image, which you can get by going to your product page, right-clicking, and getting the image link. But I prefer to actually direct upload my image so I can make sure it's of the highest quality. I also recommend adding in additional images as this allows your shopping ads to become a slider like this. Click the advanced button and upload extra images in this section below. Let's now look at price. In some niches, the most important thing here is the price. Pretty straightforward, provide the price and make sure it's the same as what's on your landing page. Shoppers can be drawn by sale prices, but we have a few other product attributes that can take care of this. Make sure to also include the currency right here. This will usually be the currency of the country that you're selling to. If your product is on sale, you can click the advanced button to unhide these fields and add in the sale price here. Always make sure that whatever pricing you put in this section matches exactly what's on your website. If Google crawls your store and finds a discrepancy, they'll just disapprove the product. Your ads will stop for that product and you'll have to fix it before being able to start them all over again. The next thing we'll add is availability. Here we're telling Google our product is in stock or not. If your product is in stock, then just add in stock here. If it's not in stock, then you can set it as out of stock. You can also click the advanced settings here and tell Google what date it will be in stock so that it automatically lists your products in your campaign once they are. Next, we add the detailed product description. You're going to add in the condition here, whether it's a new, refurbished, or used product. If you have an apparel product or a product with lots of variants, you can also select this toggle here and add in the details
for those products. Next, we have our shipping. If you have your shipping settings already set up in Google Merchant Center, then you won't have to add in additional settings here. If you haven't set that up yet in Merchant Center, check out our full video guide on setting that up. I'll leave a link down below. If you do want to set up individual shipping settings for each individual product, this is where you'd actually add that. Click the advanced button and you'll see all the additional options to go through how you're going to ship this product. Lastly, I recommend selecting this option called additional product data. Here you can add a promotion ID. Don't worry about this right now. This is for running promotions in Merchant Center. We'll cover that in another video. You also have custom labels here. We won't use these right now, but keep in mind that they do exist. Underneath that, you then have the product category. This is important. Google uses numbered categories to categorize your product so they can better understand what it is you're selling. Here, we need to go and find the actual product category number for our product. I'm going to leave a link below to this big list of all the Google product categories. Go down below, click that link, open up this list. We now need to search through this list and find the most relevant category for our product. In our example, we're selling white noise machines. So I'm going to search for white noise, and there you have it. 4056, it says white noise machines. Depending on your products, you might have to search for a few different keywords until you narrow down exactly what you're selling. Try to get as close as you can. We copy this and then go back and add it into this box. We're now going to click save. We now see this page that says our product is being reviewed by Google. We can then go to all products and our product has now been added and it's going to be reviewed by Google. It will take some time to process and get approved. While this is happening, we'll go ahead and repeat the same process again for our other products. You can see that this gets a little tedious if you have a lot of products. So this method is best if you have less than 10 to 15 products.
We have videos on setting up your product feed if you have more products than this. I'll leave a link to those videos and guides down below. Also, this video that you're watching right here is actually part of our free Google Shopping course on our website. It's 100% free with no signup required, and it shows you how to set up, optimize, and scale your Google Shopping campaigns to make a lot of sales for your e-commerce store. Everything you need in one course, it's pretty awesome. I'll leave a link to that down below. If this video was helpful, please hit that like button, let me know in the comments below, and I can't wait to see you in the next video. Bye for now.